I had an unusual experience back in 1982. I was one of the very few reporters who actually visited the Syrian town of Hama. The Assad family put down that uprising by hammering these neighborhoods with artillery and then coming in and bulldozing the buildings and literally steamrolling these whole neighborhoods flat, just like a parking lot. It's one of the most remarkable things I've ever seen. I eventually wrote it in a chapter in my book, From Beirut to Jerusalem, a chapter called Hama Rules. And the argument was that Hama Rules, which is what a lot of these Arab regimes play by, are no rules at all. You do whatever you have to do to survive. You kill however many people you need to kill. You see Hama Rules playing out again today by Hafez al-Assad's son, Bashar Assad. He's trying to play by Hama Rules, but it's a different age. And every time he kills somebody, there are thousands of tweets, there are cell phone cameras, there are video. So what I sense the Syrian regime is trying to do today is a slow motion Hama. Just not the big show, but just slowly, gradually do it, hopefully get the world inured to it, and that eventually be able to get away with it. I'm dubious myself. I think this Syrian regime is in real, real trouble. Syrians have lost their fear. They've got the technology to tell the world what's going on. And one really has to hope for the emergence there of some kind of a democratic movement. I'm also struck again by the word that really is guiding the Syrian revolution, silmiya, peaceful. Let's keep it peaceful. We're all in this together. Very striking, very unusual, just the opposite of Hama Rules.